Hi everyone, this is Mrs. Geist and I am going to talk about the basics of getting ready to play the alto saxophone. Saxophone, and this is the alto. There's different ones as you get older, but right now you are learning the alto saxophone. So if you notice, I am on the floor and I'm where a carpet is, because if we accidentally drop some pieces, it's not gonna damage it. So we wanna be really careful. We don't wanna take it out on the table or put it on our lap or put it on a chair. Make sure it's on the floor and preferably on carpet. So most important part is being, able to open the case the proper way. I know that sounds basic, but if we have the case upside down and we unlatch it, there goes the saxophone. It drops out and things are gonna get broken and your mom and dad aren't gonna be happy because they have to get it fixed. And then you're without a saxophone for 2 weeks. So let's keep it really in great shape and take care of it. Most of the time, the label is at the top, and that's how you're gonna open it. Also a good indicator are the latches normally go down. Okay, not all the time, but most of the time they go down. So that means that you have opened it the right way. Just to make sure though, you wanna open it up slowly and make sure nothing falls out, okay? Another thing I forgot to mention is hopefully your instrument came with a name tag or a luggage tag, and hopefully you have one. That way if it gets lost or your case looks like everyone else's, we'll know that it's yours and I can return it to you. It also is important just to make sure that it doesn't get lost, okay? So it can be any type of luggage tag, it doesn't matter. So hopefully you can do that. I don't want a piece of tape here with your name on it, because that's only gonna be temporary and it's gonna come off. So let's invest in a luggage tag if we can. So saxophone is a little bit more complicated than the other instruments. We have a lot of parts to it. And to begin with, I'm gonna take out the body and hopefully, crossing my fingers, your instrument came with a neck plug. This is the neck part of all, it's a part of it. And that plug goes inside of it, really important. I don't wanna go into details right now, but if you don't have it, your neck's gonna get stuck and it's gonna bend and it's not gonna be pretty. These are very inexpensive. The stores all have them, and hopefully you have that. Second thing is, I know it's really bizarre, but if you can get a sock, preferably not a stinky sock, but if you can get a sock and we're gonna put our neck inside of the sock, I know your case, you're probably saying, but my case has a spot for the neck right here. Or my case, I can just throw the neck inside this pocket. Well, what happens with the neck, if it's not secured, it bounces and flops in around in your case, and then it breaks and bends the octave key. Okay, and you'll notice that every day I'll go around when I see you, I'll go around and I'll have to fix octave keys because they get bent. So a way to save that neck, to put it inside of a sock, make sure it's not stinky. You're gonna put it in there and then you're gonna slide it into the bell. Don't jam it down there, just gently slide it in. And that way when it's wobbly, the neck will be protected more, okay? So I'm gonna put this back in because we don't need the body for quite a while right now, okay? We do need the neck, so I'm gonna take that out. Your case, your instrument should have come with a couple of things. Like my description said, you need at least 4 reeds. A whole box would be better and it's cheaper in the long run. Rico size 2, okay? So you need a whole box of those, or at least 2, 3, 4, 5 to keep you going for a while. These are gonna be expensive and we wanna take good care of them. They're very gentle. I'll show you how to do that in a second. Your case should have also come with cork grease, very important. I will talk about that on my next video on how to take care of the saxophone. You don't need to know right now. And it probably came with a swab. If it didn't, it's actually no big deal, and I'll tell you why later. The saxophone is very big, it dries itself. You don't really have to worry about it, okay? And then it should come with a mouthpiece cleaner. If it doesn't have it, again, it's not a big deal. I'll show you how to clean your mouthpiece just with a paper towel, okay? Polishing cloth, most of your saxophones came with it, not a big deal. I don't sit there every day and polish my saxophone, but if you have it, it's nice. We wanna keep your saxophone pretty, okay? And then of course it comes with a neck strap. Hopefully it's the right one. These can become very frustrating, but I'll show you later on how to properly wear the neck strap. Then it should come with, obviously, a mouthpiece. And I'm hoping that it came with a mouthpiece cap. Why is that important? It protects your reed when you're walking around or you're taking a break or something. Nobody comes by and rubs that and breaks your reed. So hopefully you have a mouthpiece cap. It came with a ligature. It's a big word called ligature. Ligature. Here's your reed and here's your mouthpiece. So what am I doing to my reed? I'm making sure that it's pretty wet. Now I just played, so my reed's pretty wet. We don't wanna break it. We don't wanna bite on it. Very thin, it's very delicate. And we don't wanna touch the top. We don't wanna rub it against anything because as soon as that reed breaks, it's like a broken bone. You can't really play. You're not gonna sound good and you're gonna be frustrated. So we want to take good care of that reed. So there's two ways of putting on the reed. I'm going to do kind of the simple beginner way first. You're going to set it on there as straight as humanly possible. I'm not really touching the top and pushing it down because that way it's going to break. And you want it to be right in the direct center of that mouthpiece. And right at the very tip where it's lined up, we don't want it to be crooked. Otherwise, your sound's not going to be so good. Now I'm gonna take the ligature. Really important to remember all this. Most of your ligatures, the screws go towards you, they face you, okay? And it's on the right-hand side. So the screws face you and they're on the right-hand side. And then you tighten it down. Most important thing is lowering the ligature pretty far. There's sometimes a line there, you want it below the line. That's something I have to quite often fix every time. So if we can remember lowering the ligature, it allows the reed to vibrate with a better, bigger sound, okay? Now, if you look at that, that's the perfectly set reed on the mouthpiece and the ligature's far enough down. I made it look easy. It may take you 5 or 6 minutes to get that reed lined up. If everybody else is ready in the class, please don't rush through this and break your $2.50 reed. It's not worth it. So take your time as you get older and more experienced. It won't take you so long. Okay, there's another way too, but I'll wait to show you that later. Now, the most important thing next is how to make a sound out of this. Now, I'm gonna kind of cheat first. It's okay, it makes it a little bit easier. I'm gonna put my mouthpiece on my neck. When I put it on the neck, it should go on the cork pretty easily. Now, I am gonna talk about the cork grease because I think most of you got pretty new rentals. And on new rentals, they put a brand new cork on it. So the cork is gonna be really dry. So I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna put some grease on it. Don't need a whole lot. You rub it in all the way around. If you don't do that, the mouthpiece will get stuck. It won't go on. And then you're gonna force it and then you're gonna bend the neck and your saxophone is kaput now. So you grease that up. Like I said, if it's a brand new cork, you're gonna probably have to grease it every day for about a week, all right? So I put my mouthpiece back on. I'm gentle not to bend anything right here. Remember, that's an octave key, pretty important to know. So I put it on. Now I don't push it all the way in, okay? I just push it maybe 40% in. You don't want it all the way out either. It's not gonna sound very good. So you want it about 40% in towards the cork or to the bottom of the cork. Don't push it all the way down. Now, what you're gonna do with your face, okay, it's called an embouchure. Big word, I'm gonna talk about it a million times. Embouchure, how we hold our face, how we hold our lips, our cheeks, our chin, all that good stuff. So now, bottom lip gets tucked in. All right, or over your teeth. Doesn't matter if you have thin lips or thick lips, that bottom lip has to be tucked in all the way. I don't want to see any lip. So all the way in. Then you put your mouthpiece right on there. And your top teeth just sit on the mouthpiece. Bottom lip in. Top teeth there. And your top lip just sits on the mouthpiece. It doesn't do anything weird. Don't roll it in or roll it out. It just gently sits on top of the mouthpiece. Bottom lip in, mouthpiece in. The biggest mistake for young players is they don't take enough mouthpiece in their mouth. Go ahead and put the mouthpiece in your mouth. And you want to hold that note out as long as possible, and that's all you're going to do for like 5 or 6 days. You're going to just walk around the house, practice putting on your reed, practice your embouchure, under or tuck it in. Take enough mouthpiece in your mouth, not too much, because then you'll squeak and nothing will come out. And you want to hold it for a really long time. Practice timing yourself, okay? Again, bottom lip in, all the way. I don't want to see any pink, which means you'll probably have to look in front of the mirror. I'll give you mirrors every time I see you so you can see what you're doing with your face and your embouchure. Top teeth sitting on the mouthpiece, top lip just relaxed. And we want to make sure our sides of our mouth are kind of firm, okay? That's how you get that sound, and you got to really blow from your gut. That's a lot of information in one little video, okay? So keep practicing that, and hopefully you have all these materials and you're ready to go. A lot of teachers will teach you to take off the reed and put it in the case. You don't need to do that. It's okay. Just put the cap on. Obviously, if you don't have a cap, please put it back in your reed guard, the plastic reed guard that you have, and then you're good to go. Use your sock, put it in your belt. And there you go. So thanks for watching the video. I appreciate it. And I can't wait to see you guys. Thank you.